projects. And we can work on some of those other good projects because they build the coalition and or because they facilitate what we want to do, like get the money out of politics, like media reform, like free college. There's nothing the military fears more than free college. You know, there's nothing you can do in counter-recruitment that will get compared, you know, to a fraction of a percent of the good you'll do if you have free college. Environmental regulations, get them to be applied to the number one destroyer of the environment, which has, you know, immunity. BDS Israel and expand it to other criminal rogue states like this one. Get the weapons out of the local police departments, build relationships with local groups opposing racism and militarized police, work with the GI coffee houses or create one, create meeting places, create co-ops, wear t-shirts every day. I have a Peace Fresno sweatshirt I wear all the time, but I think somebody's got a good one in the back, but I think you should start making them that say Peace Fresno / FBI. And wear them around and start conversations, right? Somebody says Memorial Day, ask them what in the world they want to do with Memorial Day. Somebody mentions military service, ask them how in the hell it's a service. You know, have a frame of mind that questions, and questions publicly, the whole mentality of this warmongering state. Push for little things like the United States stopping for the moment giving cluster bombs to Saudi Arabia. But they try to stop all the other weapons to Saudi Arabia and to ban and to agree with the rest of the world that cluster bombs must be banned. You know, there's another treaty. We could list dozens of treaties that the United States, not solely in this case, but among a handful of rogues, is a holdout on. It's just, we could just go on for hours and hours and hours on the things
but
you can do.
But you have a flight that you have to catch.
But I have a flight and you have your own questions. Cindy has a life to return to.
I just want to make one observation before we have. So if democracy, if elections really did solve things, we've had literally thousands of elections in this country. Wouldn't we just be the model country right now if elections did solve? So what is it, like we're not voting right? Should we like get to the voting place and then spin around three times, take a shot of tequila and walk it backwards? And then maybe it'll change? So, I mean, if elections were really democracy, and if elections really changed things, we'd be the most awesome country in the world. Because every time I turn around, there's somebody electing somebody for something, you know, right? So I'm not saying don't vote, because I vote every time. But, you know, I think taking a shot of tequila before you go is a really good suggestion. But that's like the tiniest little thing that we should do. You know, and really election boycotting, if you do it right with an education program behind it, is also something that we can do too. Or just make a commitment that you're not going to ever vote for an imperialist. Right? And whatever, you know, just whatever. So I just want to really thank David. He's mega articulate, and you can tell he's very passionate about changing the world. And so I'm just really happy that even though we do live in an evil empire, there's people like David Swanson to try and take us in a better direction. So thank you.
Well, thank you, David. Thank you, Cindy. And we have time to take some questions.
See you then.